I'm happy you're here again. Are you ready for the secret powers of random numbers? Randomness is a major ingredient in games. So, with the knowledge of how to generate random numbers, you are a huge step closer to developing your own game. Before we start writing code, you have to understand that Python is kept small and easy, and anytime we want to go beyond the basic functions, we need to import a module. This is a good arrangement. We basically only need to take the building blocks that contain the functions we need. I will show you how to easily do this. Here's an example code snippet. In this code snippet, we import the random module using the import keyword. All you need to do is write import and then the name of the module you want to use in your code. Now we can access the functions and features provided by the random module in our code. The random module in Python provides functions for generating random numbers. One such useful function is randint, which allows us to generate random integers within a specified range. Let's explore the randint function and see how it can be used. Here's an example code snippet using the randint function. In this code snippet, we import the random module and then we use the randint function to generate a random number between 1 and 10. We basically tell Python that the function can be found in the random module which we just imported. That's why we write random.randint, which is our function name. The dot notation basically means look for this function in the random module. Like every function, randint has parentheses, and inside the parentheses, we pass two parameters. We basically tell Python to generate a random number between 1 and 10. Finally, we print the generated random number. The randint function is just one of the many useful functions provided by the random module. It allows us to introduce randomness into our programs and can be handy in various scenarios. Generating random numbers can be incredibly useful in many situations. For example, in games, we can use random numbers to create unpredictable outcomes, such as dice rolls or enemy behaviors. Random numbers can also be useful in simulations, statistical analysis, and cryptographic applications. That's it for now. Play around with this function and you will quickly understand how useful it is. Next time, we will look at structured bug fixing because as your code gets longer, it's easier to make mistakes. See you next time.